His joint press conference with the Italian Prime Minister Conte, and we're going to re-welcome our panel, former White House Deputy Press Secretary Tony Fratto, Tori Whiting, the J. Van Amdahl trade economist at the Heritage Foundation, and Michelle is here too. Michelle, I'll throw a jump ball to you to pick up on what you heard as the most significant thing there. Two things stood out to me. The first one was his, and I don't know whether he said this before in such strong terms, his willingness to meet with the Iranian leadership if they are ready to meet with him with no preconditions.
Yeah, I think that's the big headline from everything that we just heard there. I would say that's headline number one. As for the rest of it, you understand why these two gentlemen get along so well, right? They agree on nearly everything. They have complaints about immigration. They see eye to eye on having more discussions with Russia, etc. So, the Italian Prime Minister also defended him on his performance, the president's performance at the G7 that was so controversial and so criticized by so many other members of the G7. But yes, absolutely, the headline is the willingness to sit down with Rouhani of Iran with no preconditions. And then the rest, I think, was kind of as expected.
Yeah. Kayla Tausche joins us as well. She's covering the event for us at the White House. Kayla, your impressions? Michelle and I were just sort of mutually agreeing that the news for me was the sort of full-throated embrace of the idea of meeting with Iran's leader, no preconditions.
Well, and that was certainly something that had been an open question since the president did meet with other leaders like Chairman Kim from North Korea, like President Putin of Russia. The president saying, I'll meet with anybody. They want to meet, I will take that meeting. So we will see whether Iran chooses to respond to that. Remember, those sanctions from the Treasury Department go back in place a week from today. Some other headlines I thought were interesting were the president's basic flexibility on immigration. He said that he wants the principles that he laid out in his tweet, and he is willing to shut down the government over it, but he says he's always leaving room for negotiation and that the $25 billion that he had been seeking for the wall at the southern border is by no means a red line. That will certainly be music to the ears of many Republicans who had feared that the president would shut down the government just weeks before the midterm elections, but it does appear that while the president is serious about that issue, he does have some flexibility. He also put a little bit more detail on the agreement that the U.S. struck with the EU last week on trade. He said that Europe is in the process of building 9 to 11 LNG terminals. Of course, that is the way that the U.S. would be able to export more LNG to Europe. That was one part of last week's trade agreement, and people had been wondering exactly how that would work, since it is the private sector that has to buy the LNG, not governments or even blocks. So to have those ports built, which the president says Europe will pay for, will certainly be one step in that direction.
Tori, let me bring you into the conversation, then I'll get back to you, Tony. What did you hear with respect to trade, Tori, between the United States and the EU and the United States and Italy? The president pointing out that Italy makes great products. I have some of them. I'm not sure what he was talking about there, but I guess he does.
Well, for me, I think the most important thing coming out of the last week or two in our relations with Europe and Italy today is that the president has admitted that trade can be a win-win. And that is a huge change in rhetoric from this White House. Previously, it has seemed like the president thinks that if another country is winning on trade, it means America is losing. And that has been a complete flip. And now we realize that when we work with our partners in the EU, like Italy, that we can all be better off.
But Tony,